So I'd like to give you just a little bit of a preface to this piece that I'm going to read. So the Osaka International Ladies Marathon was the biggest Japanese race, and I got invited to go to this race. And this is in January of 1986. And I'd just gone through this period of great independence. And so I didn't take a coach with me, but the Japanese had invited a coach. So I asked them if instead I could bring my mother and my aunt. And so the three of us arrived together, and they thought this was just incredible. First of all, when we got off the plane, there were TV cameras, and we were looking around thinking, well, there's somebody famous on the plane, and the TV cameras were for me, and my mother's going, oh, my daughter, the runner, and I'm reminding my mum that we don't, this doesn't happen wherever I go, this is fairly unusual. Anyway, my mom and my aunt Nancy were both given badges that said coach and trainer. And they knew nothing about my training and my running, so they just wanted to go shopping all the time. And so that was all pretty sweet and funny. So after I won the race, we were invited. So I'll just start reading from that part. That afternoon, we were invited down to the marathon headquarters, where a committee was preparing a post-marathon tour of the quaint old city of Kyoto for me, Mum, and Aunt Nancy. Mum and Nancy, who had come laden with New Zealand souvenirs which they had lavished on their hosts, now took the opportunity to present Mr. Chigusa, the race director and a popular television show host, with some gifts. Being an artistic type, he distinguished himself from the somber salaryman by foregoing the dark suit for wild, colourful clothing and perming his hair so that frizzy, thin, black twirls sprang out of his head. He sat at the table with his committee. Mum handed him a gift bag, which back in her room had doubled as a laundry bag. For me? Yes, we nodded in unison. He pulled the first item out of the bag, and everything was, you know, two-handed. So there is a whole protocol for accepting a gift. So he pulls out this first item, sheepskin slippers. He bowed profusely. Thank you, thank you, thank you. He went up and down. He peered again in the bag. There was another gift. A handsome hand-knit sweater in bright colours. This time his bowing surpassed his last bout, and he swung back and forth like a wind-up toy. Thank you, thank you, thank you. He put his hand into the bag one more time and pulled up another item, which he held in front of him. His body was bending into an automatic bow, but his face was crinkled with confusion. He was gingerly holding up my mother's petticoat. He looked as if he'd just been caught stealing panties off a clothesline. my mother looked up and she swiped it from him with a sharp, "That's mine." And he's looking all sheepish. And then we all started laughing, and we laughed till we just cried ourselves silly. We had belly aches from laughing so hard. So it was the best gift of all. It's my mother's petticoat.